recording him.
Sheikh Kirya was murdered last night at 10 p.m. in Wayogerere while returning from prayers at a mosque near the Kabakaz Lake in Indeba, a Kampala suburb. He was shot along with three other people. His murder comes at a time when 11 other Muslim clerics have been shot and killed in a similar manner. Muslims accused government and police of failure to protect their leaders, yet they have appeared severally on the wanted list by unknown assailants. Most speakers accused the rival faction of Old Kampala as the cause of the deaths. Outspoken Sheikh Nuh Muzata, the head of imams in the country, chased in Sanji LC3 chairperson Ajabdul Chiemba from the prayers. Haj Abdul Chiemba is attached to Old Kampala faction. The Inspector General of Police, Kale Kaihura, and Third Prime Minister Moses Ali, who represented the president, were in the hot seat as the head of imams, Nuhu Muzata, accused them of non-performance. Among other things, he accused government of responding to Muslim murders only through monetary condolences. Kaihura, who was broken, had few answers for the hard questions from the angry Muslims. He told them that he was operating within the law. Third Prime Minister Moses Ali endured the hardest moment, with the bereaved community almost refusing the 10 million condolences from the president. He was buoyed several times.
To the family. Yeah, they were, the instruction I had is to give them a book. And I cannot throw it on the street. I must give it so that it helps for the purpose.
And that's why I'm saying that the late was the spokesperson of Chile administration. And we have the secretary general of Chile administration. So I believe that if one to hand over Mamugo, Haj Samira is there. The Supreme Mufti is around.
He advised Muslims to vote out the government in 2016 if they feel tired of it. Muzata gave Kale Kaihura up to Monday to shut down Masjid Nur Mosque, or he will mobilize a riot in the city over the same. The head of sheikhs in the country, Obed Kamulegea, said the president had slowly forgotten the Muslims in the country and added that he will announce the decision they will take after the holy month of Ramadan. Prince Kasim Nakibinge, the head of Islam in Uganda, however, said they would continue engaging police and government.
Sheikh Kirya's death is testimony that a lot has not been done to protect these people. One person dead is one too many, but we are talking about five sheikhs gunned down in a period of 6 months. This is alarming, and government should wake up and take heed, or else the situation of lawlessness is going to come in when brethren take actions to defend themselves.
Slain Sheikh was laid to rest at his ancestral home in Nkoowe, Wakiso district, and he survived by four children. Edward Muhumza for Urban TV.